Bam! What's up? Amelia and Tia here. Hope you guys are feeling good and doing good. Feeling good, I'm doing good. And I got a great topic for you today. Welcome into my vehicle. Let's ride. I'm headed somewhere. So I have about, we got a nice 20 minutes. I was like, yeah, let's pop in. Because the Lord came heavy on me yesterday, honey. I was like, woo! Y'all don't understand, so fam. It's going to be an amazing year. I don't know about y'all, but if y'all don't start claiming it and doing the work, then I don't know. But if you doing the work and you being patient and you being realistic and you being love, so fam, you got it down. You got it down this year. But what I wanted to add to that is free up some space, soul fam. Okay? Free up some space. See, what's happening is the Lord got these new blessings for you. The Lord got these new beginnings, you know, these fresh starts, these new paths. Okay? New paths, soul fam. And if you are stuck in your old past, on your old path, in your old ways, then you're gonna miss your call. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be distracted. So this is a time to not be distracted at all. And if there's something that you really want to do, if there's something you really want, is this something you've always wanted to do? Do it. You have the support of the Lord. That's the best support you're gonna need. Let me say that again, Sophia, because y'all missing it. Right now, you have the support of the Lord, and that is the best support you are gonna need. So, you know, some of us, we get a vision from the Lord and then we go to people for the plan. God gave you a vision and you gonna go to man for the plan. So fam, learn how to get on your knees and pray and ask and clear your mind. Some of us, we don't know how to clear our mind and be as still and listen. And it takes discipline. So if you've been following my channel and you've been doing the work along with me, because I've been doing the work too. As I go a little, I give a little. And I encourage you to do the same. But you have to realize that this is a process. Some of us, we still waiting on an Uber Eats direct order. No, it's gonna be a little step, and you have to be grateful of each step. You know, it's like first grade, pass the test. Second grade, pass the test. Third grade, pass the test. Fourth grade, fifth grade. You get what I'm saying? But this time, you're not in grade school. This time, you have chapters of your life, okay? How are you handling this situation? How are you handling that situation? How are you dealing with things in the past that keep trying to pull up? Because you can't ignore it. You can't block it out. It'll keep coming back. You got to nip it in the bud. How are you nipping things in the bud? You have to ask for strength. You have to ask for courage. And you have to ask for clarity. Wow. Come on. You have to ask for clarity, Sophan. When you trying to move forward in life, right? And you're trying to put your pieces together. It's like a puzzle. It's like a pizza. You know, everything must come together. A pizza is not pizza with just bread. That's bread. A pizza is pizza because it has sauce, cheese, pepperoni and whatever you like on it, and then whatever toppings, and then you have a pizza. But separately, those things are just those things. So in your life, so fam, you have to wrap everything together. You have to look at everything 360. You have to do the work 360. If you owe some apologies, send them apologies. It's only gonna fix and help your heart. You're not doing it for nobody. Some of us, we have too much pride and we think we losing because maybe we lost the battle. The fight is not in the battle. The fight is the war. The war against you and your old ways. The things you did at those times. There was times where you were hurt, you were broken. So what do hurt and broken people do? They hurt and try to break other people. So you might have been one of them people. And okay, now that you have fixed yourself, now it's time for you to fix it. Fix it. Face it. Own up to it. That's all you could do. The best thing you could do is admit when you're wrong and move on. Because the fight don't end as long as somebody don't want to take a loss. Be the bigger person. Trust me. It's less headache. I don't argue with people. And one thing I don't do is argue with people who don't apply knowledge. If you don't apply knowledge, I don't argue with you. It's, to me, I feel like everyone has their right, their point of view. They're entitled to their point of view. If that is their point of view of the situation, okay. You share your point of view. And if they still want to argue, give it to them. Like, okay. All right. I'm sorry. Most of the time, we sitting around, you know, dragging situations on, thinking it's literally your situation. So, fam, the battle is the Lord's. So, if you're in a situation either way, yeah, do the best you can. But it's still not your battle. I'm not even going to go too crazy on that part, but I just want to definitely say that. Because some of us forget and we start fighting, doing the Lord's work. Like, let the Lord do his work. Do your job. Some of us don't know how to do our job. We're trying to do everybody else's job. When you go into a job, let's talk about a real job. They give you a job description. They say, this is what I need you to do, and this is what I'm going to pay you to do. The Lord did that to everybody. The Lord gave everybody a job. This is your job. Do your job and go about your business. When you do your job and you go about your business, oh my Lord, when you do your job and go about your business, you be overjoyed. You're overjoyed for no reason because your mind isn't taking up the space and your emotions aren't all out of whack because you sit here trying to fight everybody's battle. Focus on you. When you focus on you, everything falls in place. I remember not too long ago, but you know, I was always the person who kind of like to lean on, like somebody who come lean, you know what I'm saying? And I'll be quick to just be like, yeah, you know, I'll be giving the whole body, you know, sometimes you want to just give people your all. But when you want to help somebody, sometimes you give them your whole body when you're unaware, you know what I'm saying? And just trying to hold everybody's problems and fix everybody's problems physically was draining. So draining. I didn't recognize who I was. You know, I was just like, I looked in the mirror one day and I was just like, who are you? I was like, Q, where are you? I was like, oh my goodness. Like, you see this, you know, when you stretch, you be like, what the? I was like, what the? Oh, Lord. You know, I was like, oh, Lord. I was just like, oh my God. And I'm not talking about the physical. I mean, a little bit of the physical too. But just the way I was behaving, you know, these traits that I've developed, I was like, that is not who you are. You do not, you never was that person, you know, and you never inspired to be that person. So why are you that person? And I checked myself, and then I focused on myself, and I'm still peeling off layer by layer, peeling off pieces that people have put on me that was not mine, you know, like, wait, this is not insecurities. This is not mine. Somebody put that on me. Let me get that back. You know, manipulation. I was like, this is not me. Let me get that back. Lying. Desperation. I was like, who? And then I looked at myself again. I was like, you took that. Someone put it on you, gave it to you, and you accepted it and you took it. But guess what, babe? The Lord is giving out refunds. He said, give it back. Return to sender. Refund. So, fam, I went and I just was getting refunds. Refund, refund. And what happens when you go to the store and get a refund? Most places, they don't like to give you a refund. They like, nope, they say final sale. So when you go back and you force that refund, like, no, take it back. Oh, well, they're going to be mad. These people are going to be mad. They're going to be mad that you giving back the pain that they gave you. They're going to be very upset, so fam. Oh, my goodness. But it's now their job to go tackle it. It's not my job to tackle this for you anymore. I've held it as long as I can. I held it as long as I could. And I am no longer holding this for you. So I'm going to give it back. Okay? With grace, with peace, with love. Cause when they gave it to you, they didn't know what to do with it. So they gave it to you hoping you could do something with it. And that's what you did. You took it for those years, you held it, and now you're giving it back with grace. And that's the best you can do. That's the best I can do for you. The best I could do is give it back in hopes that you see that the problem is not with me. Okay? I'm not here to hurt you. See, oftentimes when you're giving people their pain back, now you're the bad person. You are, you know, every bad word in the book. Am I? Because last I checked, I'm just getting my refund, which I am entitled to. Because, first of all, when you gave it to me, there was no policy. So the Lord told me the policy. I went and did some homework, and the Lord said, give it back. Mm-hmm. So when you start giving it back, so fam, you start freeing up some space. You start freeing up some space for laughter, for love, for peace, for bigger than money. You know, if you think about money, wrong channel. Sorry, can't help you. That's a lot. Money will come. It's not about the money. It's about your mental health, so fam. It's about your state of mind. It's about your ability to make decisions. It's about your ability to think. Can you think through this problem without losing your cool? These are some things that they don't teach you in school. Free up that space. Make room for what is actually yours. Okay? Make room for what is actually yours. Because over the time you have filled up your space with things that was just not yours. So go get a refund. Metaphor. Rewind the clock. Metaphor. And don't cheat yourself this time. Don't cheat yourself this time. If you cheat yourself this time, the reward won't feel as fulfilling. Lord showed me that too. He said, trust me this time. Last time you didn't trust me, and it showed. This time, trust me. Some of us don't even know what trust is. He said, go back and do some research and learn how to trust. Learn some trusting exercises. And once you master that trust, that's how I want you to trust me. And that's why I said so, fam. Don't go to man for the plan. Because the only person you could trust in this process is the Lord. So you need to learn how to go ask him yourself. You need to learn how to hear his voice. You need to have clarity. You need to heal. Because if you don't heal, you're going to get mixed signals inside. You're not going to get a clear signal. And the signal has been so clear for me than it's ever been in my life that I can't even believe. I'm just like, no way, this is my life today. And then I say, yes, this is what I've been working for. This is my life today. Thank you. Thank you. And all I can say is thank you. Like, I owe so many thank yous that I'm just so overwhelmed with joy that it's just like, I don't even have anger. It's don't, even when someone's angry, I don't even feel it. And some people say that's toxic. You don't feel pain. No, I face pain. When I see it and recognize it, I don't let it take over me. Some of us, we let pain take over us. And now we're operating in fear, and we're confused, and we're missing our blessings. Because we think everything is against us. We done went against each other so long that we don't even know how to solve a problem in peace. We're so, definitely black people, so quick to call somebody your enemy. And so quick to accept when somebody is trying to be your enemy. Because we love to point. No pointing. Only looking in the mirror. All right, so fam, watch this video twice. Like I told you, I got 20 minutes. I got one more minute. I'm about to arrive. Do the work. So fam, trust the process. Smile a little bit. Keep smiling till it's genuine. Keep smiling till you really feel it. And then laugh. And then laugh and then laugh. Laugh at it all. Laugh at yourself. Laugh at the things you did as you grow. Because it's done. It's done. You made it. You're still here. You're still alive. What else can we do? Upset? I'm sorry. I've been upset so much in my life that I don't have the energy. I've exhausted the energy that it just doesn't live in me, and I don't welcome it in me anymore. Like, no. And when I see it coming, there's a better way. There's a better way. Nope. There's always another way. So, all right, so fam. So Starbucks, but I see the line too. So I'm gonna keep going. Anyway, so fam, Amelia Adair here. Thank you so much for tuning in. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'm gonna see you guys at the next Wednesday.